Our departure time is 2300. Get your bird started and I'll meet you on the runway.
Pull up! Pull up! Altitude! Altitude!
Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, radio check. This PO...
One, copy.
The ability to deploy flares is an important combat capability. Flares help illuminate the battlefield, making targets easier to visually identify. Flares can also be used to deny the enemy a tactical advantage by illuminating an area the enemy would like to occupy. Effective flare deployment is not difficult, but must be practiced to learn the best techniques to ensure maximum flare illumination and longevity. How do you like flying in the dark? I'll fly close trail formation so you won't have to worry about it midair.
Cobble Eddie, Colt, 1-1. Request taxi to runway. 1.
Rolling.
Cobaletti, Colt, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, been able to clear for takeoff.
Cobble Eddie, Colt, 1-1, request takeoff.
Colt, 1-1, Cobble Eddie, you are cleared for takeoff and ready. Climb 300
one.
At rolling. AFT29.86.
Performance check starts now. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2, fly heading 245, Angels 8, and maintain an appropriate speed. Hard deck limit is in effect. Do not go below Angels 5 unless the restriction is terminated. Approaching Angels 8, level out and maintain appropriate speed. Good. Maintain 245, Angels 8 and appropriate speed. Use of the autopilot is authorized. Let's review the mission profile. Threat level is low, so this will be a high altitude profile. Our first target is at waypoint 5. It's a row of trucks, as per the briefing. Your task is to drop flares to illuminate the target area so the trucks can be seen. The second target is a group of artillery at waypoint 6. Illuminate the target by releasing flares over to the target area. Your last target is at waypoint 7. It is a moving convoy, so you will need to use the targeting pod to locate the target area. Once located, drop your flares in an appropriate location to illuminate the targets. Let's review the details about the LUU-2 high-intensity illumination flares you will be using. The LUU-2 Bravo flare has a light output rating of 1.8 times 10 to the 6 candle power and will illuminate a circle of 500 meters at 5 lux at 1,000 feet altitude. The flare burns magnesium at a high temperature, emitting an intense, bright white light. The consumption of the aluminum cylinder that contains the flare may add some orange to the light. The brightness will fluctuate as the flares burn at uneven rates. With the introduction of night vision goggles, flares are not used as frequently as in the past as they provide too much light for the NVGs. Cold 1-1, Cold 1-2. Turn right to 330, maintain Angels 8 at an appropriate speed. Delivering an illumination flare is much like delivering an unguided bomb using CCRP mode. However, the difference is that only manual release mode is used. Let's get the Dismas set up so we will drop two flares over each target area. Select the appropriate weapons profile and change the release type for the LUU-2 to PRS, pairs. Do not forget to save the profile. Colt 1-1, Colt 1-2. Turn right to heading 065 and maintain Angels 8. approaching hostile territory. Let's review the fence-in checklist. Navigation lights off. CMSP mode as desired. MWS switch on. JMR switch on. RWR switch on. DISP switch on. Master arm switch arm. Gun pack switch arm. Laser switch arm. TGP switch on. Dismiss weapon page. Verify weapon settings. Dismiss missile page. EO power on. Damage check. Fuel. Check and report call sign fenced in and fuel state.
Call 1, fence in.
Call 1, 2, fenced in, fuel 4-3. When dropping the flares, we have to make sure we are below the cloud deck, or drop the flares through a hole in the cloud deck. Cloud formations generally reduce the probability of target acquisition by scattering the flare light. Strong or gusty winds can blow the flare light off target. For moderate winds, up to 20 knots, flares may be dropped with wind drift taken into account to drift over the target at the time to provide effective illumination. We are approaching the IP. Let's review the ingress checklist. AHCP, verify settings, dismiss weapons page, verify correct weapon selected. Attitude, check speed and altitude, CMSP, verify settings. At the IP, call sign in hot from deck and your direction. You are at the IP. Make your radio call and commence your attack run. You are cleared and hot. Flares will drop with each press of the weapons release button. Release the flares when ready. If you cannot locate the targets, you are permitted to circle the target area and re-engage if required. Do not stray outside the MOA. Well done. Target in sight. Let's head to the next waypoint for your next target. Check the target area. Check the target area.
away.
Well done. Target in sight. Let's head to the next waypoint for your next target. Well done. Target in sight. Playtime is over. Time to head back to our egress point. Now call off as we are exiting the target area. Let's review the egress checklist.
Colt, 1-1, off.
Heading, check to friendly airspace. Caution panel, check for lights. Flight, check status and fuel. Radio, report if required.
Colt, 1-1, off.
Colt, 1-2, off. Good pass. Clean. We're back in friendly territory. Let's review the fence out checklist. Master arm switch, safe. Gun pack switch, safe. Laser switch, safe. TGP, off. CMSP mode, standby. Damage, check. Navigation lights, on. Fuel. Check and report call sign fenced out fuel state. Colt 1-2, fenced out.
Colt 1, fence out.
Warning, autopilot.
The hard deck restriction is terminated. You're permitted to land and shut down your bird. I'll give you a rating then.
RTB. Two. RTB. RTB. Cobaletti, Colt 1-1, inbound.
Colt 1-1, Cobaletti, fly heading 068, Fort 1, QFE 29.86, runway 25, to pattern altitude. Landing.
Altitude, altitude.
Take the taxiway to the right. You can park in the first free revetment on your left.
Congratulations. You passed this PO. You received a qualified Q rating. Well done. Return to Cobaletti for the next qualification mission.